Hello everyone, I'm Alcina Teles, physiotherapist in Brazil, and I am very glad to be here today to share with you the results of our study about the lead as a new therapeutic option on symptoms of genitourinary syndrome of menopause, clinical study phase 1. These are our disclosures. With the life expectancy increasing, we are having many more women going through the change and the period of the post-menopause. And one of these changes, or some of these changes, leads to a syndrome called genitourinary syndrome of menopause that includes sexual and urinary dysfunctions, which can impact negatively on the quality of life of these women. Up to 50% of these women can develop the syndrome. And for women that are not on menopause physiologically, it's possible to reach a percentage of 15% of them. And they can have the symptoms of the syndrome for using of hormones, for example, and surgeries. It is known already that the blue lead used in mucosa, oral mucosa, can have positive changes, can bring positive changes to this tissue, having the photobiomodulation. It can be seen as circulatory, regenerating, bactericidal, and anti-inflammatory effects. And recently, our group has published 2 studies about the use of the blue lead in women that are healthy and women with candidiasis, using the lead on the genital area, demonstrating that can be a safety and effective treatment. This study aims to evaluate the 405 nanometers blue lead intravaginal safety and effects on the genitourinary symptoms of menopause. This is a clinical study phase 1, which precedes a randomized clinical trial in women with genitourinary syndrome symptoms, and the inclusion criteria were thinking about the age, they should be between 18 and 65 years old and having at least one symptom of the genitourinary syndrome that can be vaginal dryness, burning sensation, changing of the sensation of the genital area, urinary incontinence. So there are a few symptoms that are possible. And the exclusion criteria were if these women were pregnant or had hormone replacement for less than 5 months, vaginal infections, or impaired in comprehension. At the baseline, all the patients went through an amnesis, a physical evaluation, and also on these questionnaires to be evaluated about the function, the sexual function, the self-genital, self-image of the genital area, and the perception of the symptoms according to the visual analog scale. The treatment itself was made in 3 sessions, once a week, using the lead for 8 minutes in the intravaginal canal. This is the device that was developed by Dr. Lordelo. During each session, the patients would report about adverse events and would say how they would feel. After 1 week and 1 month of the treatment, the reevaluation was made. 11 patients were treated. The mean age was 55 years. And according to the sexual function, it was possible to see that 8 out of 11 patients had an increase after 1 week of the treatment. And 5 patients kept the increase or had additional increase after 1 month of the treatment. Regarding the self-genital image, after 1 week, 8 patients also had an increase on this aspect. And after 1 month, 6 patients kept the increase or had additional increase. About the symptoms, the genital symptoms, the most important one that all the patients had was the vaginal dryness. And after one week of treatment, 8 out of 11 of the patients had an increase, had a decrease of the symptom of vaginal dryness. And after 1 month, only one patient didn't have any improvement on that data. When asked about their satisfaction about the treatment, 9 patients felt that they were or satisfied or very satisfied about the treatment, and no side effects were reported. In conclusion, the blue light treatment seems to be safe, demonstrated improvements in sexual function as well as on genital self-image, also associated with reduction of the genitourinary syndrome of menopause complaints, revealing potential therapeutic effects on this condition. Thank you very much.